go to item number 15, the fast talking executive director, Dr. Lance Kenny.
Howdy, y'all. It's the other schools. My quarterly meeting report is in here. If you want to see the different actions we've been doing over the last period. If not, I'll head into the next bullet, the strategic plan, Journey Toward Excellence. This one doesn't have an exhibit, but I do want to mention normally about this time we're working on a strategic plan, and then every other year we put together an actual formal one as required by the legislature, and in the interim years we put together kind of a summary and do some activities related to that. I spoke with Dr. Wong, as well as the fact that we have the merger coming up in here, that developing a strategic action thing at this point is about to all kind of change. So we've already started a process like that where we're having our staff retreat and gathering information on directions we should be moving forward. So that process will be continually ongoing, and I think we'll have a whole, we'll have to work on a new mission and vision for the agency and other things like that in the combined. So it'll be a work in progress as we head toward the next round. We still have a, we're still doing the main things we've been doing for the past between licensing compliance and our education outreach activities. So and we form our internal teams and things like that. So
the next thing I want to put something, you know, we used to have a separate meeting for our strategic plan. So we are planning to do that once we have a new board or when we have the new name. So plan on to maybe I will work with Lance to arrange some time either the same day today, like you know we'll do it afternoon or do it two different days. So I'll kind of check with your schedule, but we will have a very separate meeting so that we can plan on look at what the direction we have, especially with new board. So we need all your participation. So I just want to make sure that have that in mind. We'll let you know what the when we'll do that.
The next item on here is the serving board status update, and this is the same document I gave during the legislative committee meeting, and it is in here in its entirety. But I want to let everybody know, besides the bill passing both houses and heading now, maybe after conference to the governor's office, it looks like more or less it's a lock on the window. Still a couple of days to go. But all that being said, we're not waiting for it to be finished for us to start. We've already had several meetings, whether it's attending their board meetings, engaging with them at NCAAS. We've already started engaging with their staff, had them over here a couple times. We've been working with them, setting our, right now gathering our list of actions, and the next thing we'll be starting assigning the tasks and prioritizing what needs to happen in the short term, medium term, long term, and start making this kind of thing happen. Everybody's on board that we're going to make this, we're going to make it happen effectively and efficiently. As I mentioned on the outreach thing earlier, I've already given an outreach presentation to the Surveying Society, so we're going to make it all happen, and it's, and I think it's going to be a good thing in the big picture. So, this specific action.
Are you going to get your survey license?
If you can meet the qualifications.
Me?
Whoa!
I don't think I meet the qualifications.
Whoa!
I have been serious.
You forgot about using a transit.
I need more letters. So, I know it's you know, it's complicated to get license. I don't think but so these are the actions. If you have any questions on things we have done so far, obviously any inputs and feedback. And did you want to mention about we'll be looking to have some kind of work group at some point?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, we'll be working.
We will actually have a work group working with Lance and the staff to kind of like plan on this. So I need your volunteer. If you'll be interested in serving the work group, let me know. And we're going to appoint that group very soon. You're happy to, so just let me know at the time, and yeah, so have a lot of interest, so yeah, that'll be great, and so I'll drop you also, so, but just let me know if you're interested, we'll get that group going very soon.
Okay. the next thing is the Regional Advisory Committee in the Rio Grande Valley. This is the third iteration of our advisory committee meetings that we've been having around. This last one, well, I would say, is the biggest one we've had so far in conjunction with UTRGV, both Brownsville and Edinburgh campus. There's a brief summary that I included in here. A number of staff came, a large number of board members, so I'll throw that out if anybody has any comments on how it went down. But it was very strong engagement from the Dean of Engineering there. Very hosted through, I really rolled out the red carpet to make this thing happen. We invited a bunch of people, and because of the capacity on campus, in previous meetings we've had kind of a 100-person kind of cap and limitation. This time we opened it up to over 200, and we had 212 people sign up, attendance at about 168, and they stuck around through the board panel, which is always interesting. I learn things every single time in the commentary. It could have gone even longer, to be honest. Then they have the presentation and then licensing thing. So lots of folks attended, lots of people engaged in it. Overall, I thought it was very well received. So I want to thank everybody that traveled down there for and kind of jokingly, Mr. Rubiano, when he joined the board, I don't think you expected that the first thing out of the gate was to become. He was on the phone and texting and processing. So I want to thank you. I know we wrangled you into this right out of the gate. So thanks for all your help getting to make this happen. And everybody else that helped when they was there. I think it went well. Anybody who attended, throw it out if you have any comments on the events or what you thought.
I would, if I may, we received quite a bit of feedback after the event from our local engineering community, and they were very appreciative of the time, the venue, and they were amazed how many board members came down and came to that. Thank you all that dedicated so much time and travel to.
I think the most important thing that came across was encouraging the students, and there were a bunch of students that attended, the importance of becoming a PE.
Great. I appreciate everybody that attended.
Thank you very much.
There's some pictures in here. You can see the attendance and whatnot. So we'll start the next round. I'm not sure exactly where it's going to be. There's been a couple of names thrown around, so we'll figure out where we're going to go next.
Yes, sir. The only rule was that it might be the
Oh, you want to turn this off?
We talked about that last time.
Well, y'all let me know where the next one is. Generally, we've been trying to go toward, if you will, the corners, the places we don't go all the time. So to me, there's maybe a panhandle or an El Paso kind of thing. We'll have to see really where the board wants us to go next. We'll start engaging, but we'll start planning this next round, and it'll be set for fall. So,
good. If I may, Mr. Chairman, if TSPE can reach out to their regional chapter, offer any invitations that might help identify what.
We will always do that. They've been helping us a lot.
Lovato is very engaged and active, and the student chapter there is largest, most active. They come to the conference, they come to the national conferences, they send 10 to 12 students to everything.
Well, it's a long way out there. That's maybe one of the reasons to do it is a UTEP kind of thing. So we don't get out to UTEP, to be honest, very much.
Very, very strong student group. And the dean, she's spoken at our conference and at our board meeting.
I work closely with Dean Maldonado once in a while.
Yeah, and she also does the change lab.
So we'll throw that out.
We'll discuss it.
The next items I had on here were the NCAAS meetings. I'll try and give a short summary. We just got back. Some people quite literally just got back. Window, I guess you just kind of landed and then turned right back around and came back out. A good meeting. Combined Western Zone, Southern Zone meeting in Boise, Idaho. We had a very strong showing of attendees, so I want to thank you for coming. They came, including all three of our new board members, so I appreciate you coming in and seeing what NCAAS Zone meetings are about. Lots of good stuff. I have a summary in here that's way too long for me to read, so I'm going to do that. But it did have, there will be some items to talk about at the annual meeting coming up, a couple of things related to technology and research tech steps, and they're having a national discussion, an interesting discussion on whether or not the 16-hour structural exam is actually a PE exam or something else. We've always counted it as if you want to take the 16-hour exam as part of your initial licensure, go right ahead. But some other folks think other things. So there's the summaries are here. We'll, of course, know more about it as the motions roll out. We are going to do, there's a webinar that NCAAS does, and we'll do a webinar in preparation for those that are going to go to the annual meeting as well. So we'll talk about those items so we're all prepared like we usually are and have our votes figured, at least initial votes figured out. So for those that attended the Zone meeting, any questions, any comments if you want to about Boise? It was drizzly while we were there.
I think it was first time for me. I think I enjoyed it. I get to network and meet some people.
And the next
I think we broke the record on attendance for Texas. For Texas. I don't think we've ever had so many representatives in the meeting.
It's good.
Very good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, thank you very much. And it was a great learning process. And Nicole. Thank you. was very informative, and a lot of them gave us a lot of information which was very crucial to us for a new member, you know. And Lance and Bobby sitting right across the table, they were all the time being helpful and said, hey, now this is what they are talking, this is what they are talking. So thank you both of you very much.
Very welcome. That's why you got up and got away so much. Maybe I needed a breath mint.
It was the ministry. Okay. Yeah. One of the things, the next thing on here is just that the annual meeting this August is in Washington, D.C. So please, I believe registration is open, so you can sign up. Let us know if you're interested in going. We've already gotten a couple of the funded delegates signed up, but really we can support everybody. So as many people as interested, please sign up. Let us know, let Chris know if you need to help in any kind of arranging of travel or any of those kinds of things like that. I want to piggyback on the book. Yes, you can.
And the next
I was going to say,
I paid about $10 to say that. Next Zone Zone is in Houston. It's not a Southern Zone. It's like a mini national meeting. All the four zones are combined meeting in Houston.
Right, so the next spring meeting is in Houston, but it's all zones at the same time. So in the same way we just had a double zone meeting, it's going to be a four zone meeting. This is an idea they spun off a couple years ago based on how the architects groups do it, and so this will be an opportunity. We're going to see how this format works out. I believe after that we're going back to having four individual meetings, but this is it. See what happens. You know, does it lose its flavor? Can the zones keep their flavor? We're going to see how it goes.
What is our effort? What is our financial?
It's nebulous because it's a large group and large contracts, so they're handling most of the stuff. We've reached out and said if they need anything at all, Texas will be
happy to help. When we talk to staff members who arrange this, they came out and said, don't worry about it. We got everything.
But we will tie in if we need to have come in there and give your
invitation
and welcome.
Sure.
And greetings and stuff like that.
We did that. The site of the meeting will be in a hotel that's connected to the gallery. That's the only scary part.
Yeah,
for the members from Houston probably need to work on the feeder. Or back and work with the Houston members to
drive the gallery.
To come and talk about it.
We'll support NCLS in any way to make
whatever, it. Whatever they need, yeah, right. We'll support them.
The next one is an update on the building. We're at the 60% phase, so we've gone through, this is on building renovation ideas. We've talked with the architects and the engineers, and they've come in and gathered our needs, wants, and all those good things. They put together some initial drafts. We gave them feedback on round one. We're now through round two, and we just had a meeting the other day again to have more of our ideas shared. So I wanted to just put these in here. I don't think it's a case of going through all of it yet. We haven't nailed it down at all. We've worked with Mr. Bailly and Mr. Shaw as far as liaising and sharing the information. They've given us some ideas on expansions, on how to build things out differently inside the building. So the good thing is I think with our current building, we'll be able to provide more workspaces by reconfiguring, for the most part, the other side, the working side of the building, not the executive side, and making more of an open floor concept. And so there's some maps in here, diagrams in here, and so we're still providing some feedback. They've given us different configurations, but I can say that the team that's working on it has been really receptive to our responses and been able to, in almost every case, incorporate that. So we're going through the next round to run through, and we'll see how much closer we can get. But I think we can get from our 30-something capacity now well up to 50 by reconfiguring some of the building and maybe adding some features. We'll start working in our budget constraints and whatnot as well as part of the design. So.
Just one question.
Yes.
Now that this boardroom is not good, it's really good, but as part of the renovation, are you going to have like a board-centric room, try to change things around? The reason I asked that was, if I look at I saw new videos, which is good, cameras. But last time I was trying to watch myself from the meeting, and I can hardly see myself I saw all the stuff. So I was showing it to my daughter because my first one meeting. Uh-huh. I said, where are you?
Yeah. One thing I can say, so we did some AV upgrades in here, and we'll see. Take a look at the next meeting. We got a new camera, and you can see everybody now. Before, everybody was kind of like a vague blob, if you will. Now we can see you. And so we'll see how this comes out. But we did went ahead and did the AV upgrades because it's going to take some time before we're able to actually renovate the entire place.
What I meant by board-centric room is like a C-shape.
More like that.
Yeah, with microphone, podium. I don't know. That's just my own.
Yeah, we'll see if we can fit that out. Right now, the design is keeping... if we stay inside the building shell without changing it, that right now it doesn't expand the order too much.
I would like to all the board members, if you have any ideas, let's like that, and just give it to us.
And we'll throw it in.
We'll throw it in, and then we'll present to you. Once you see the budget, you'll say, wow! You'll say, cut. But anyway, we'll entertain all your suggestions because it's important. Please provide suggestions to us.
Yeah. Square foot per employee is still, I don't want to say minimal, but it is very, very conservative. It's small. It's small to medium. They're not spending a lot of, they don't have a lot of lost or unusable or non-used square footage there. They're good numbers compared to your office type square foot per employee.
The importance is how efficiently we are using our space.
That is right.
Instead of going by square foot, it's better that we should utilize it efficiently, as efficient as possible.
Yeah.
Without wasting time.
Correct. And a lot of space out of boardroom that we don't really use. We can use for training, but not used a whole lot.
Yeah. I'll keep plowing through this real fast because so, outreach report here, summary is in here. Once again, you already saw the performance measure. We're doing a ton. We're probably going to cross over last year's double threshold. Last couple little items, we did a couple things we do each year now. We've judged at the state science fair as well as went to the TAME competition, so there's a report on those with some pictures from the events. Great projects, as always. The TAME event is always intriguing to see what these students go into. It was a lot of fun. They had to do, for Ms. Norwood, they had to try and fish out things from a whale board that were lost at the bottom, and they had to do it all between meeting their team to full project in an hour. They had to figure it all out, so that was a lot of fun. And the science fair, of course, there's projects that you just think are like, wow, I didn't even know there was a deal with my high school student. The top one we gave out an award for each one, but the top one, I believe, I can speak for the rest of the team that helped judge, was a young man that helped redesign a chest pack that was magnetic that would allow astronauts to be able to attach their tools to themselves. In a more efficient way, actually got some bites from NASA and the designers on this might be a good idea. So that seems to not just see a cool project or a well-done project, but you start getting someone from the outside going, what are you doing over there? So it's nice to see that's the, every time I go, I come back thinking, well, the future of engineering is pretty much, it's all right, so it's fun, and next year we'll do it again, and we'll invite everybody who wants to be a judge to help everyone who's at College Station, and it may be for a while now. So, with that, kudos. I want to thank everybody who does outreach. We do tons of it, like we say, and we're out doing it around things. All board members are doing the same kind of thing. So, with that, that's the end of my report. And after we finish up the meeting, we will be saying, for better or for worse, goodbye to Mr. Howell here, who will be retiring. So, cake and goodies and some other things. And right after the board meeting, so go as fast as we can.
I'll eat your share. You can leave. I can eat these two cakes. It's mine. All right. Thank you so much, Lance. Any questions for Lance, please? All right, let's go to...